Hey guys, I was just listening to this little section of Avery Shannon-igan publicly stating that she would never put herself in a position to harm her own livelihood or to put herself in jail. She just said that. And this is a conversation between her and the fake saint, real snake Mo, who doxed me. Do I dox her? I think her name is, what's her name again? Cook, something, where she cooks cats. Yeah, Mo Cook, where she cooks cats and eats them for snacks for dinner. Listen.
Because I have a child, two grannies. I have goals in life. I would never.
So do I, hun. And you actually, Avery, you actually harmed my ability to make money by scaring the shit out of me with your hitman antics. And now you're laughing at that. You threaten another woman who has children, who has grandchildren now, who had a grandchild on the way back then. You're a complete and total fucking hypocrite. With an emphasis on hippo. Crit. You got a lot of nerve.
No, you're not hippo.
You're stupid. This woman actually, Avery Shannon, actually wreaked havoc in my life, and everybody saw it, but it was Mo that was the worst. So I was like, well, Avery really scares the fuck out of me, and so does Mo. She's being a vicious bitch. She was just relentlessly bashing me on Jimmy's chat for the longest friggin' time. It was so painful to see it. Now, I was making videos, my own videos, communicating with Jimmy, directly to Jimmy on my own channel, at my house, my YouTube street. He would come over to my street and listen to my videos. Jimmy likes my videos. He thinks I'm funny. We understand each other, same sense of humor. Jimmy and I go way, way back. It doesn't mean Jimmy is always good. He's not. This is where a lot of women misunderstand about Jimmy. Chrissy doesn't know Jimmy from a hole in the fucking wall. Chrissy is so ignorant about Jimmy. It is just like, really, Chrissy? She just can't. She's one of those people that's so good. She's so good, but she kind of dumb sometimes. Misjudges people. Chrissy drives me crazy. With all due respect, Chrissy, you bashed me one night, Chrissy. So I'm always going to be a little mixed about you. Bless your calls are like, are you kidding me? She's so behind on all the stuff. She never does her own research. And she walks in, she calls Jimmy's chat with that high-pitched, crazy friggin' voice, with all due respect. And I'm not in love with her voice, so I'm always like, oh, shit. And those calls last for fucking ever. People think that mine are the longest. No, I think Chrissy's are the longest. She hands down. And she's not a member. She never sends him money. I don't know if she sends him other stuff. She loves Jimmy. But she doesn't understand who Jimmy is. She's literally so blind to who Jimmy is, it kind of shocks me. So these two women were big, huge financial supporters of Jimmy's. Avery Shannon and Mo Cook, fake saint, real snake Mo, who gave me this super fake apology. I don't know if she ever meant it at all. She did apologize publicly. Avery never did. But Avery tried to pretend it wasn't her fault, like a true sociopath. At least Mo was a little more honest, like, yes, I was a bitch to you. It was so obvious. But what Mo... And Jimmy was on my side the whole time. Jimmy did not want to harass me. Jimmy did not want me bullied, but he also didn't know how to handle these women. And he was struggling with trying to figure out how to please his fake saint, real snake Mo, and to please his a huge financial donor to Jimmy, and was always complimenting his ass, and, oh, you're the greatest thing on earth, and, oh, I have, you're amazing, like, over-gushing. And in my opinion, over-gushing, I'm like, what are you, serious? Come on. I mean, yes, I know Jimmy on a soul level. We go way, 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 way back. I find him here, and I'm like, dude, what the fuck is going on here? What do you mean serial killers? Dude, what's up? What's up? And I liked your comment, by the way. This is where Jimmy is funny. Where he says, Jimmy... He does speak, like, I listen to him to hear for what he says about this whole thing with the hitman, me, the trouble I'm in. He tells me, you watch your butt cheeks, Team Rose. You watch your butt cheeks. And he's serious when he says it. He points at me. I know he means that. And I'm like, he's warning me because he knows the truth. And these women who laugh at their accusations of me, these women who made, look, making a poster. making fun of. This man, he already called himself a hitman. What is wrong with you women? Just because you might have made the poster, whenever you made the poster, he was already calling himself a hitman. Are you stupid? Did you forget? I mean, you women, I don't know what is wrong with you people, you know? I'm not a criminal. I actually literally go out of my way to not be a criminal in this lifetime. I've never really been a criminal. I've always been good. I'm a good soul. I'm an old soul. I'm one of the ancients. I'm very beloved. I'm very loved, beloved. I'm a beloved child of Source, you know, some of us are. And I'm very highly protected. And thank God. Otherwise, I would have been nailed a long time ago. This is what these bitches, these mean girls, the mean girl club. I mean, the fact that Jimmy had Mozilla, fake saint, real snake Mo, call herself Mozilla, which was the name I gave her in my videos expressing my experience with dealing with these mean girl bitches. Because Jimmy, he doesn't, these mean girl bitches, Avery Shannon-igans and fake saint, real snake Mo, they were so controlling. They were throwing all this money at him, huge amounts of money, showing off their wealth, I guess. You know, here's fake saint, allegedly, you know, engaged to be married. Yeah, sure. And but obsessing over Jimmy, you know, and controlling his life, his chat. Now, he liked a sense of, he liked having like this badass bitch woman who was protecting him, you know? I think he felt protected sort of by, you do feel protected if she really likes you. But the thing is that, you know, Mo, when you're really nice, you're really nice. It's almost a bit much where you're like, wait, see, when people gush like that, I'm always wondering. It was a little, because it's like, what are you talking about? You know, you're treating Jimmy like he's some sort of god, which I'm sure is great for his ego. And that's why he calls you saint. But it's not realistic. What kind of friend are you to act like he's this god and throw all this money at him? It's psychotic. I see it as insane. You think I'm batshit crazy? No, I can recognize a man and with his good points and his flaws. And I can say, hey, man, you got some good points and you got some flaws. Let's work on this. I'm here to help, you know, choose the right path. This is what it looks like. You don't just throw all this fake worship and money at a guy. Well, what about yourself? What are you doing? What are you women doing? Then these women demand that the chat and his channel go their way, or they're going to throw a little fucking tantrum. And they think because they threw all this money at him that they should control his chat and who comes and who stays, who goes and who stays. And Saint Fuck wanted me, Saint Fuckaroni, Saint Moaroni, Saint Fuckamotoroni. Yeah, Saint Fuckamotoroni. I like that. Saint Fake Saint Fuckamotoroni. You can use that. You can borrow it. Fake Saint Fuckamotoroni. It's perfect. Real Snake Fuckamotoroni. Fuckamotoroni, baby. You gonna fuck that Motoroni? Is she Motoronying? She's got a federal, she's a criminal. She's got a federal, she was in federal prison. That's a crime, okay? You can choose to not do any crimes and still end up unlawfully, you know, illegal. Well, I don't know why these are illegally, unjustly thrown in jail for a crime you did not commit. This happens to people, okay? Let's put a stop to it. Team Rose, Systems Busters. Come on, guys. Let's choose actively with our hearts and our minds awake and aware to actively choose. Choose a card. That was my daughter's little first computer toy. Choose a card. I made a joke about it. I said, choose a hill. When you want to choose a hill in the hills of Tennessee, where crimes are free and every hill has eyes. Oh, yes, they have eyes. And those eyes are looking. What are they looking for? They're looking for you. They're looking for you. And do you have a child? Are you willing to give up that child? And how can we make you want to choose to give up your child when we want it and need it? How do we get you little human idiots hooked on drugs so easy to control the bloodline? Is it the bloodline that's so easy to control? The blonde, blue, the green, brown. Who are you people? Who are you people? You're the hypocrites from Hippocrates. Remember that old asshole? Well, he was an old asshole. Let's listen.
No, I'm not stupid.
Oh, you're not? Wait a second, sweetheart. You're not stupid in certain ways. Well, succubuses, I mean, what the hell? I don't know. Do they have any brains at all? I'm not really sure. Why? What kind of brains are we talking? You mean stupid? You're not stupid? Well, let me ask you this. Are you a hypocrite? Are you two-faced? Did you turn on Jimmy? Well, let me ask you this. Did you tell Jimmy in a phone call publicly for all the world to hear to never have anything to do with that BK goat man, or she would come after you? She would personally beat you up, Jimmy, if you turn to the dark side and join the goat man panagram club. Oh, you will be on her shit list, Miss Shenanigans, Mr. Abe Re-Shenanigans. She will be angry with you if you join that bad, bad man. That bad, bad man who picked up a big fat fucking log and practically threw it at a woman or something. MGL stood there seeming like she had a gun in her pocket. She seemed like there was a gun hiding in her jacket. That's what it looked like to me, but I wasn't there. I don't know. I didn't ask her. She said she wasn't afraid. Come to me, she said in her overly raspy, weird, emotional voice. Come to me, come here, in a New Jersey, a Jersey accent. I can't really do her right now. I tried to be a fan, but I don't know. I've turned on that. I don't know, because she became a BK Pananogram club gal. She hangs with the goat man. Oh, he's harmless. Oh, really? He cut a dog in half. He killed a dog with one stick. One stick hitman. Jimmy said, let's make up serial killer names for this hitman because he knows he is one. Listen to his words. You can't hide it, Jimmy. Not when I'm in the chat. No, you can't. Because I'm going to bring the truth out of you. Good or bad. Dark or light. Ugly or not. Cute. Sexy. Funny. Dumbass, whatever you bring to the table, dear, it's going to be the truth. That's the way it works. That's the way it works on Team Rose, which you are on.
But I hacked somebody's account, I damn sure wouldn't do it. I know, but stuff is
you useful. Bitches made fake accounts about me, especially you, Avery. You really had it in for me. And you and Saint Bitch, the one who's not batshit crazy, because only the cool people are batshit crazy. You're just bitches. You're just bad women. You're hypocrites, two-faced. You have no spine. You switch back and forth. What did you say, fake saint, real snake Mo, that you would never leave Jimmy or True Blue? What a bunch of bullshit you turned out to be. You're going to come back to Jimmy. You and I are at war. Right now, I win. Right now, I'm in the chat. Is it a win? Well, I noticed a few changes with Jimmy. Is Jimmy someone I plan on and expect high things from? Yes, Jimmy. And you will produce. Yes, you will. You will rise to the occasion, Jimmy. Yes, you will. And you will only speak the truth, Jimmy. And you will only speak the truth to me. Mm-hmm. That's right. No matter how manipulative you might tend to be, back in the whatever, doing whatever, you know, plotting and scheming, it's part of a sting operation, right? Kind of like a sting operation. Hey, you know, you're not the only narcissist, you wicked witches of the East and the Midwest. You're naughty, naughty, naughty. These women made fake accounts. Pretended that I threatened his daughter and said all this mean shit and sent it to him publicly during live shows that I was in. And I loved being in that chat. This woman, she wanted me out of the chat for her own selfish reasons. She did not have a big enough heart to want another woman A fellow female, this is how women go against each other, but succubuses, of course, do not like goddesses, obviously. But she could not respect that another woman who was grieving her mother. I was grieving my mother. I was desperate. And I was grieving the loss of my family. My sisters had betrayed me. My brothers had betrayed my mom. They threw her under the bus, watched her get run over twice, and did literally nothing about it. They actually went against all common sense, and they went against what was the right judgment and common courtesy toward my mother. She could not even get common courtesy out of these two sons of hers when she needed the most help. They abandoned her. That's how I see it, because that's what I saw. The oldest brother acted like he wasn't involved, and that is your biggest mistake, that you allowed your younger brother to make this huge mistake. You didn't care. You didn't even bother to visit the place. You only bothered to visit when I had mom. Then you showed up to look and see. But did you bother to go when your younger brother took over? You didn't even bother to look. You didn't even go to visit it to make sure it was okay, because I bet you bottom dollar, well, I don't even know who you are anymore. The old brothers would not have allowed my mother to be in a fucking place like that, you sons of bitches. With those horrible old ladies and men sitting in those chairs frozen, making those horrible sounds and drool. Not a single intelligent person. How dare you disrespect your mother? How dare you disrespect your mother? And you mean girls, you disrespect me. And you can go to fucking hell for that. Because you bring everybody down. I'm shoving you off. We're shoving you off, bitches.
Put it out here right now, too.
This is the... All right, here's the voice. Here's the voice of the biggest bitch, okay? The fake saint. Everybody saw her apologize to me. I immediately accepted her apology, not really understanding what the hell was going on. She apologized to another... I tell everybody openly what my channels are. I'm not hiding it. I can't even do the fake names. I'd love to. I don't even know how to do it. I'm like, how does everybody change their name? They accuse me of changing my name. I'm the only one who doesn't change their name. I have 3 accounts. You're so fucking stupid, you women. You're boring. But, you know, I'm talking about you right now. Because why? Because I'm trying to give you a message. I'm trying to make you good women. The good women of Earth, the real women, okay? You know who you are. Let's sweep these bitches away, and we will do what's right.
Shame to fucking admit it, because I changed and I'm different and I don't act up and do stupid shit no more. Yes.
You used to do stupid shit all the time? Fake saint, real snake, well? Well, you're the biggest hypocritical bitch at all. Do you think that anyone believed your fake attempt to befriend me? I tried hard to be nice to you. Why? Because I wanted peace in the chat. Because I respect the fact that other people besides my selfish self want to be in a chat for their own personal reasons. Saint Mo, you're not a saint. You're an actual demon. I wish you'd become a better woman. I can't say I have a lot of faith in that. I'd like to. I'd like to see both of you stupid bitches act like better women. Can you? I don't know. I just don't know. My focus has been Jimmy, because I need to, because I know Jimmy from, Jimmy to me is an old soul with all his flaws or whatever, with his wishy-washy whatever. He is going to rise above, okay? We all got confused. I'm here to help you clarify your reason for being here, your mission, okay? Listen to these fake fucking bitches, man. You know, I wanted to like these women. You know, when fake Saint Mo is nice to you, it's great, but she overdoes it, and she was all over. She would answer, people would ask me a question in the chat, and she would answer it for me. I'm right there, and she's speaking on my behalf, but not even saying the truth. She called me a failed actress, really? Well, I think getting into a famous movie with Sissy Spacek and Marissa Tomei, one of the best actresses in Hollywood is Marissa Tomei, by the way, and so is Sissy Spacek, and Tom Wilkinson got an Oscar for that movie or some, you know, that movie won awards. It wasn't a B movie. Just because you didn't like it doesn't mean it was a B-rated movie. No, it got awards. It was very well received, and I was in it. So fuck yourselves. And I was also, I had the whole screen to myself for a good 3 to 5 seconds, okay, or whatever. I got the whole screen to myself. Did you? No, you did not. Do I get royalties from that? Yes.
I do have a record.
Yes, you do.
I have been to prison. Mm-hmm. I've been to federal prison.
Well, thank you for letting us all know that fake Saint Mo, real Snake Mo, the biggest bitch I have ever seen. You do get the crown for being the biggest bitch. Avery is the biggest sociopath. She's the one who tries to hide how evil she truly is. But fake Saint Mo is just an overt bitch. It's like the it's like the overt narcissist and the covert narcissist. Both playing victim. Now the overt narcissist, the fake saint, you know, she's just an aggressive bitch from hell. I mean, I've never seen anybody treat other people so rudely while saying don't be rude. It's like screaming don't be rude at everybody while being so rude, so condescending, so mean. I literally was shocked every time she opened her fucking mouth in her giant blue, accusatory, threatening. She's like a mean fucking nun in the old strict Catholic church. She's like a prison warden guard. You better rhyme warden. That would be her perfect job, is warden. You know, badass bitch from fucking hell, but not a good one. Oh my God. I was treated so badly by this relentless. And then she would stalk my Facebook page with her team of bitches. Tanya Henderson. Despise that woman. Fake that Lord's will. Fuck that fuckery. Faggot fuck. Sorry. Sorry about the F-A-G-E-O-T words just slipped out. That's how I was raised. That's all my older brothers said. You have to accept my apologies or don't. But you know, I know what gay guys call themselves. All of them. All of them. Okay. It's like black people can use the N-word and gay guys can use the F-A-G word, which is, by the way, really fun to say. And I do miss it. But anyway, listen.
It wasn't anything. Well, how do I put this?
You money laundered, bitch. Why don't you get, how do I put this? What the fuck? Shut the fuck up. Why don't you do a crime against other people like you do to me? See, these bitches are sitting there acting like they're better than everyone. And we've got a federal criminal who's been to prison. And then we've got this. Avery Shannon posted a video to Jimmy. She showed a video to Jimmy about the psychotic woman who wanted views in true crime. She wanted to become famous in true crime and she hired a hitman. Avery, remember that, Avery? I made a video about it so all the world will remember it. And you made this video about this woman and you went in to show him this with your nervous little voice. And you were so in love with him. Shut up acting like you weren't in love with him. We all know you were in love with him, hun. You can't take rejection. It's like BDAC. Nothing bad has ever happened to that guy except for Ernie Schill disappointed him a little bit because Ernie was just, you know, doing a lot, whatever. It's not easy for everyone to pull off things who are part of the Illuminati bloodline. BDAC. And BDAC had never suffered. He's had everything handed to him so easily that his big letdown in life was Ernie Schill. Just a little too sexy, just a little too good, and so bafflingly wonderful that how can you bring him down for rejecting you? Did he reject you? Did he not act humble enough for you, BDAC? Was that your biggest pain in your life? Was that Ernie Schill didn't act humble enough for you? After you gave him money. So you're going to bring him down for months and months and months. No. Go fuck yourself and grow up, BDAC. Poor little baby. Get over it. Back to the bitches.
It wasn't anything like...
Like what?
It was a misdemeanor. It was a misdemeanor, actually. It was a...
You went to federal prison for a misdemeanor, bitch? Oh, sure. Why didn't you lie? Like you lied about me saying I did all this to you, meaning us. Some us meaning you. No, I only meant you, Mo. I meant you, pretty much you. She's acting like when I was letting Jimmy know in my funniest way that I could that his top fake saint and those lords and saints were just ruining the chat. And I said it in the funniest way I could. And fake saint, real Snake Mo. She took it personally, but she decided to make it about all of them because that's what narcissists do who are soulless. They can't take responsibility for their own actions. Also, oh, well, she did give me the fake apology. But that was for a long-term plan. She thought she was going to pretend to be my friend, that I was so stupid that I'd believe her, and that she would collect data and information about me to share with Avery to make it easier for the hitmen. And I think they were in it together the whole time, and I think they still are. And that is my opinion from dealing with these two fucking mean girls that are at the top of the mean girl club. I'm glad Mo is out, and I hope she never comes back. It's like the best thing in the world that Mo is out. So many people hated being timed out and blocked by this fucking bitch. Even Jimmy's friends were getting blocked by this fucking bitch. And he didn't know what to do because she worshipped the ground he walked on. And it was just like, And these women who throw this worship and all this money at these men and then expect those men to be obedient to them. That's not, that ain't how it work, bitches. Works, bitches. Did you do this to Manimal yet?
Felony misdemeanor is what I'm not a felony misdemeanor. I had a federal misdemeanor is what I had. I did not have a felony. But when you are federal, you still go to, like, say, if you break probation, then you go to prison. It doesn't matter if you have a misdemeanor or a felony, you still go to prison. And that's what happened.
You broke your thing? Stupid.
I went to prison. That's my past. And they want to put my past out there? Okay.
Yeah, let's put your past out there like you put everybody else's out there. You were so stupid that you broke your probation? Are you some kind of idiot? Aren't you a mother? What is wrong with you criminal women? You see, that's why I don't trust these women. This is the kind of judgment they make. Yeah, that's stupid, Mo. You're a mother. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you for making women look bad, for doing the wrong thing, for attacking me for months. Do you know what you did to my psyche? The reason I survived it is because I'm strong as fucking nails. And I cried a lot. You're a mean bitch the way you put me down. Relentlessly. You fucking cunt. You know, listen to this bullshit.
I just did.
I was very wrong for doing that because I was listening to them. You know, me and you didn't talk.
Yeah.
So
that's because you could not stand Saint, fake Saint, real Snake Mo Avery, and you know it. Nobody likes Mo, even you, when you were pretending to be friends, which you are pretending to be now. They don't trust each other. No fucking way. These are the fakest bitches you'll ever meet. These two were working together, but they didn't really like each other. Avery never liked Mo because nobody likes Mo because Mo was such a fucking bitch. All she does is, at least, you know, in the chat, Avery was nowhere near as vicious. It wasn't like that. That's not how Avery operates. Avery doesn't operate by just overtly attacking people and blocking people. That is not the way Avery moves. Fake Saint, real Snake Mo, however, the felony criminal, the one who's so stupid she broke her probation, even though she's a mother. I don't know when she did this. I have no idea. I don't know her story. Oh, I'm just listening to this a little bit now.
Being told was from Tracy and Kim.
Tracy and Kim. They bash poor Tracy. You know, honestly, they're so mean to Tracy. They call her stupid. They just are so mean to Tracy. And I see Tracy over in the Goatman's chat. I'm like, wow. What you doing over there? What's Steph Hammond doing over there? Talking about the art of war? That is clever. How can you be on BK's chat when he works so hard to destroy our Ernie? I don't get that. I don't get that.
Stupid ass was believing him. And that day when I went live and I showed your record.
Avery, I'm disappointed in you. You should be a better woman than this. I don't know. You know, I don't know what to do about people who do what you do and pretend you didn't. You know? I mean, honestly. See, the women who fall in love with Jimmy, I often don't get the attention that they want. And thank God I'm older than Jimmy and I don't have that kind of relationship with him. I mean, we're like twins. We're like boy and girl twins. Only I'm older than him, way older. I rank way higher, but he is a cosmic comedian and he is, you know, a soul traveler. We do travel. I usually beg for him to come. I was like, Jimmy, you're not coming on any more fucking missions if you don't pull this off. And I mean right fucking now, buddy. You know, he's doing it. I mean, I know he's doing all this bullshit, but look, hey, on the other hand, the two bitches that are the mice who I'm actually afraid of are out of the chat. This is a heyday for me. I'm like, yeah, baby. Yeah, baby, this is a heyday for me, right?
I know, I shouldn't have done that. And I've apologized. I was wrong for that.
I don't know what you're talking about, but you never apologize to me, bitch, and that's one of your flaws.
No problem apologizing when I'm wrong for something.
You never apologize to me, bitch, and you're pretending you didn't do anything to me. That's one of your tricks. But you did. You did. And I have all the it's documented. And then you tried to pretend it was somebody else making fake accounts. Who are you? Are you women making fake accounts? I make other accounts. They're not fake accounts. They're my accounts that I own up to and that I created and I tell everybody about. You know, you people, it's like, I'm so, the brain confusion, the idiocy, these demons, these succubuses, ugh.
Okay, because the thing is that I admit it, you know, like I've talked about it to numerous people before, so it's okay, honey.
And look,
no, honey, it's not okay. What you do to other women, bashing other mothers, is wrong. You're complete bitches for it. Change your ways or get the fuck off the planet, because this planet is raising in frequency and she's not accepting any more bitches, witches, demons, or succubuses. So I don't know why you're still here, but
not state prison, no. State prison, if you have a misdemeanor and you,
yeah, try to cover it up, fake saint, real snake Mo. You should really get a job at a prison being the warden. And Candace should be in that prison. And you should be being mean to Candace. That's how life should be. If you want to be on this planet, you need to work at a prison as a warden with Candace as a prison mate. I don't know what should happen to Shannon-igans.
Fuck up your probation, then they send you straight to... I'm sorry. If you have a misdemeanor, you don't go to prison for state. It's only in federal. If you're federal and you mess up, the only reason they send you to prison if you have a misdemeanor is because there are no actual jails that will keep a prisoner or a federal inmate that's on mm-hmm. misdemeanor for a period of time. So they send you to prison.
Sure.
I'm just remembering because Tanya Henderson is in here.
I hate that bitch.
And the reason that was even brought up about that I looked to see where Tanya lived is because Tracy was getting pissed off at things that Tanya was commenting in the vent room.
Yeah, we all hate all of them.
Tracy messaged me and said she was getting mad about it. She was getting sick and tired of Tanya, blah, blah, blah. And then she started saying, I bet you she doesn't even live in Bora Bora. And I thought, oh, shit. You know, now that
all these excuses.
And I happen to like Tanya. So I
just told Tracy, like Tanya? I already looked. Tanya's a bitch.
And no, she didn't live there. She lives in... I just told her some random state.
Tanya is a bitch.
Just to get it to
Tanya, ugh, hate that.
Just to hate her. Not to go any further. She did the same thing with the Lord's will. She was mad at him, didn't want him in there. She had me remove him off Discord.
Wow.
I still have all the messages of her telling me.
Good for
take
her.
Take him off Discord. Good. To do this, to do that.
With who? Lord's will?
The Lord's will. Mm-hmm.
I hate that fucker.
He was pissing her off because he was taking over her channel and preaching to everybody.
Really? What a dick.
Isn't that what her channel is supposed to be about? The vent room? To vent?
You know, in the beginning, she kept saying that she wanted it to be the vent room, but it kept turning into talk about Jimmy. And I told her, I said, that you have to realize everybody who came over here to the vent room with you is everybody who just left Jimmy's room. For you, so of course that's what everybody's going to keep talking about.
Exactly. Yeah, I never went over there.
So true. It was too. I mean, I'm not gonna lie. The first bit of that channel was all about Jimmy and me.
Yeah, you used to see everybody. Oh my god, I thought that this was a section actually, where. Saint fake Saint Mo was saying that how horrible it is to talk about someone's kids or something. I'm like, both of you made fun of me for weeks on end. And Avery really scared the fuck out of me. And I told Jimmy that too. I said, Avery, you know, Mo is an overt bitch. I didn't talk about Mo. I never said a word about Mo on purpose. Never. I never said a single negative word about Mo, even though she was bashing me. What I did was make my own videos expressing my experience, but I never used her name. Avery, I said, she scares the fuck out of me, Jimmy. All right, I'll be back. Love you.